So, Will, here we are in the evening sunshine.
Yeah.
Echo and the Bunnymen going on stage very soon at Cornbury Festival. You're doing a lot of festival dates at the moment. Is that something you guys prefer?
I don't mind doing them. I quite like it. It's very painless, just in and out, you know. Short sets, all the hits, get on with it. Catering, you know. It's nice, you know, when it's not raining.
Yeah, of course. So, well, this is the thing, though, about the short sets. Is that something that is easier for you guys then to kind of, when you come to thinking about, you know, what the set list is going to be for that evening? Is it easier than thinking about
we
maybe...
We kind of do the same one yeah. for a while. You know, there's a few things we juggle around a bit, but they have all the main ones, if you like, you know, Killing Moon, etc. That's always in there. I don't think we've ever done a set where we haven't played that since we wrote it, you know. So, we just... do what we can and we throw in the odd new one, but you know, we know what people want to see when they come to see us, you know. It's not like rocket science, is it?
It's pretty easy. I'll just get you to hold the mic up a tiny bit if that's alright. Okay. Talking about like the festival crowd and everything, because there's a pretty mixed bunch out there now. You obviously haven't been around outside, but it's there's all age groups.
We've done this place before.
And do you like it? Do you like that kind of mixed crowd then?
Anything, you know, line them up, we'll knock them down, you know. I'm not bothered.
You guys have been around the block now for a while, and I'm just wondering about, like, kind of, there's a lot of different acts on here. There's some new acts on the bill. You know, there's like a kind of a boy band, Lawson, they're on as well, and but the Proclaimers are on, and you know, you've got Keane as well. And just talking about like how you managed to kind of be successful for the amount of years that you guys have been around. How do you think that the younger bands are going to cope with that sort of thing?
It's difficult now, isn't it? Because everything seems to be instant, and if you're not like instantly selling loads of records, you get dropped. Whereas when we started out, the record labels stuck by with bands for a while. Like, you know, I think our first album did 30,000 copies or something. Now you'd just be dropped straight away with that, you know. I think it's changed. Everybody wants instant gratification. You need to slow down a bit and just think, build things from a grassroots level, and it'll last longer, be better, better quality.
And when you talk about like building stuff, do you mean like when you guys started at first, I guess that you did a lot of small places, a lot of small, and it was it hard work? Was it kind of going around
gigging? No, because we were young kids and we wanted to do it, and it was, you know, it was, we thought we were the best band in the world, you know, and we were taking on the world, and that was it. But we were never really sort of, I particularly didn't think of it as a career or anything like that. It was just, this is good, you know what I mean? We're in a band and we're getting... Yeah, I was getting pretty much the same money as what I was getting as a commie chef. So it wasn't like a fortune, you know, but it was a lot better than go to work every day.
So would that have been the backup career then? If the music had fallen, would you have gone back to being a commie chef?
No, because it's too hard.
Yeah.
It's a really difficult job.
Do you still cook yourself now? Or?
Yeah. I do. I'm better now than I was then. Yeah,
and so, and do you like any, what do you think of the whole, just talking about the whole celebrity thing and how like musicians do really well, what about like, do you think it's weird in the last number of years than how all these chefs have done really well, and you've got now got this ethos of the celebrity chef?
It is a bit weird, but you know, we had Fanny Craddock, didn't we? Well, I did, you probably didn't. You know, they've been around for years, them sorts of things. It's just, you know, the Galloping Gourmet. Who else was there? Keith Floyd. It's just people like to watch food on the telly, don't they? They love food, like, you know.
Makes you hungry, people, I suppose.
Yeah, these cookery books that they sell, most people don't even... They just buy them. It's like food porn, isn't it? You know? they don't actually make any of the recipes. Like, when I get them, I only make about two or three things out of it and forget about them.
What's the most recent cookbook then you bought?
It was... God, what was his name? Simon Rimmer.
Oh, from Something for the Weekend?
Yeah.
Do you like him?
Yeah, he's good, yeah.
What did you make from
his
book?
He does a lot of veggie things, because I'm veggie, and, try and be veggie. I think it was beetroot and had some sort of cheese in it. It was feta.
Oh, you're
tarts.
Making me hungry now.
Beetroot and feta tarts.
I'm seeing something. I'm seeing, like, if you went to a publisher, you know, something interesting and different here. Echo and the Bunnymen do cookery books. Would that work?
I'm up for it. I'll do it.
Fantastic. Listen, thank you so much for chatting to us.
Okay.
Have a great night. Enjoy the rest of the festival.
Cheers.
Thank you, Will.
Lot.